Gurunji Senior Secondary School, CBSE, Namakkal.
Successful, result-producing school in state every year.
Administered by the Board of Directors with over 35 years of experience in the teaching field.
Special attention on art, craft, music, dance, silambam, yoga, skating and karate.
Focus on Hindi Sabha and Spell Bee Olympiad exams.
Smart class for effective and innovative learning and well-furnished library.
Solitary importance on sports and games in state and national level.
WhatsApp facilities to know activities of students and school inside the campus.
NEET, JEE, IIT coaching experts from Rajasthan and Andhra Pradesh along with our effective teachers.
Admission registration for classes LKG to plus 2.
Kurunji Educational Institution, Kavetipatti, Namakkal. Admission in progress. CBSE, KG to 12, contact 9025895176. Metric 6 to 12, contact 9344567484. For online admission, log on to www.kurunjischoolnkl.in.
Hi students. So in this video, we are continuing lethal genes information. So lethal genes, so some more information. So lethal genes are some more information only. Second example I have taken. Why? Because in a previous video, we have discussed, you know, lethal genes means definitely genes which causes the death of an individual. So likewise, we see, you know, so there, first example I have given related to the animals. So related to the animals means, what is the example we discuss? Yellow body color and normal one. So of coat color of mice, mice we see, no, adima, suppose capital Y is there, means that particular one causes, or homozygous yellow color that causes the death of particular yellow colored mice. So means due to the presence of capital Y. So here homozygous allele or homozygous nature, no. So in embryonic stages only, so death kind of symptoms or in a death stage only, or embryonic stages itself, we can find out the death. Likewise, we have seen, so one example of lethal genes. Now in this particular case, no, here one more example I have brought for you related to the plants. One example we have discussed related to the animals. So what is the example we took? Mice coat color we see. Ipo in plants point of view, lethal gene was first discovered by Amma. Is a scientist is there, no? So Baur, scientist name. So this particular person found lethal genes in plants. Suppose, for example, if you take there, no, lethal genes was first discovered by, or was discovered by Cunot, C-U-E-N-O-T, Cunot, we see, no. So, where in coat color of mice, means animal related point of view, Cunot scientist, we need to remember, and plant related lethal genes, who discovered first means Baur. Ama, idi nalla save panikonga. Why? Because in lethal genes, so in animals someone discovered, one scientist, and in plants, no, some other scientist. But in both plants and animals, so not by same scientist. Emma, so adi matto try to remember panikonga. Now where this particular bird discovered or observed this lethal genes first means in snapdragon. Snapdragon means Antirrhinomagus. Antirrhinum is there, no? So there in Antirrhinomagus, snapdragon a common name. So there Baur scientist observed lethal genes in plants first. Now example point of view, now let us take a snapdragon. So golden leaves. Amma, this is example. So in monohybrid cross, how we have taken parents, capital T and small t as parents. No? So likewise, in a lethal genes of plant related example, so in snapdragon, we are taking golden leaves as one parent and green leaves as another parent. Now golden leaves, capital G, let us take, and green leaves, small g, let us take. Okay. Now example explanation concerned. Once you see golden leaves, so capital G, and green leaves small g we took. So thereby in F1 generation, definitely what is the information we can find out? So capital G, small g we can find out. So this one is definitely golden leaf. If the combination of these two, definitely what we can obtain? Golden leaf. The main, say here the capital G is the dominant over the small g, no? So that's why here the capital G characters only expressed. So that's why here capital G characters, what it is? Golden leaf. So that's why time we have written like this. Ipo, what is the point for obtaining of F2 generation? Emma. So in order to obtain of F2 generation, what we have to do? F1 into F1 self-pollination we have to do, isn't it? So now here F1, capital G and small g, and one more F1, capital G, small g. Ipo, in a heterozygous condition, so we know very well. So suppose if any parent is being as like a heterozygous, means definitely from that two different types of gametes formation takes place. Ipo, capital G means, from the capital G small g to, so what are the types of gametes formation we can observe? Capital G one and small g another one. So likewise from here also two different types of gametes formation. Emma, ipo paringa. So these two, let us take here in the checkerboard, means checkerboard or Punnett square is there, not there. So here, what are the two gametes are present here? Let us take here, and these two gametes, let us take that. So means here, when we are going to cross, you know, between these two, so thereby one we have to consider as a male and another one we have to consider as a female one. So now let us cross. So capital G crossing. So capital G has come, and capital G small g has come. Next one, capital G and small g. So this one and small g this one. Ipo, how many number of parents are going to be produced? 4. Ama, here going to be produced. Okay, means still not form agela. So in a future chance is there, but here what is the point here we have to remember, means suppose if we are finding in lethal genes, one point we should not forget, what is the point? No, in lethal genes, suppose if you are finding homozygous dominant characters, if you observe, means homozygous dominant characters, if you observe, means these kind of characters in embryonic stages itself death point you understood. So thereby homozygous capital G characters never obtained. Point purinjita. So here capital G characters never be appeared or never be obtained. So means here explanation point of view, here for chance is there for the formation we are studying, but during embryonic stages, because of the presence of capital G present together, that particular offspring will not be obtained in the future. Why? Because when both homozygous dominant capital G are present together, so instead of a formation of one particular organism, it leads to the death of an organism. I'm a point you understood. So that particular point you try to save in your mind. That's why for giving of a clarity, here I have written like this. Once you see here, homozygous golden leaves, idama, homozygous golden leaves are never obtained. So thereby modified ratio is, ipo idi not formed means remaining how many are there? 3 are there. Heterozygous golden leaves 2 and small g means green leaves. So thereby golden leaves 2 and one more green leaves 1. So that's why here also ratio must be 2:1. Emma, so thereby here what is the point here we have to save in our mind, means in lethal genes, so ratio definitely always will be in 2:1 ratio. Emma, 2:1 ratio. So this particular point you try to save in your mind, means so we have seen one example related to the animals. So there also we found the ratio is 2:1, and in a plant related also one more example we have discussed. So there also we observed modified ratio is 2:1. Why? Because here in both cases, so both animals and plants, definitely in both cases, what is the information we are discussing? Homozygous dominant characters never be formed or never be obtained. So why? Because homozygous dominant or the golden or any kind of yellow colors, means dominant characters, so homozygous dominant characters never be formed. Okay, why? Because when a homozygous dominant characters are present together, definitely leads to the death of an organism. I hope you people understood this. Emma, now let us start to discuss one more small concept, that is Emma, what it is? So that is pleiotropic gene. Pleiotropic gene. Once you see there, pleiotropic, P Cleo means many tropes, means like a characteristics. So one gene. Okay, so pleiotropic genes means many varum, but a pleiotropic gene dana kurtachi. So thereby here, what is a mini we have to discuss now, means we have to learn, means once you see there gene, a gene which controls more than one character. Ama one gene da irukke, even though one gene is present, that can regulate or that can control more than one character. அம்மா புரிஞ்சுதா? மீன்ஸ் பிளியோ மீன்ஸ் மெனி, ட்ராபிக் மீன்ஸ் கேரக்டர்ஸ். ஸோ மீன்ஸ் ஒன் ஜீன் தட் கேன் ரெகுலேட் மெனி கேரக்டர்ஸ். ஸோ தட்ஸ் வை ஹியர் சிம்பிளி வி ஹவ் ரிட்டன் லைக் திஸ் ஒன்ஸ் யூ சி. ஸோ ஜீன், வென் ஒன் பர்டிகுலர் ஜீன் விச் கண்ட்ரோல்ஸ் மோர் தென் ஒன் கேரக்டர் இஸ் நவுன் ஆஸ் பிளியோட்ராபிக் ஜீன். அம்மா ஸோ ஈஸி தான், வீ கேன் அண்டர்ஸ்டாண்ட் வெரி ஈஸிலி. நெக்ஸ்ட் ஒன், திஸ் ஜீன் ஷோஸ் மல்டிபிள் ஃபினோடைபிக் எஃபெக்ட். கரெக்ட் ஒன்லி நோ. ஸோ திஸ் பர்டிகுலர் வாட் இஸ் அ ஜீன் இஸ் தேர் நோ, தட் பர்டிகுலர் ஜீன் ஷோஸ் வாட் இஸ் தட் அம்மா, மல்டிபிள் ஃபினோடைபிக் எஃபெக்ட். மல்டிபிள் மீன்ஸ் மெனி, ஃபினோடைபிக் மீன்ஸ் வாட் ஆர் த கேரக்டர்ஸ் விச் வில் பி எக்ஸ்பிரஸ்ட் அவுட், இசன்ட் இட்? ஜீனோடைபிக் மீன்ஸ் உள்ளே, ஏமா ஃபீனோடைபிக் மீன்ஸ் வெளிதான். ஸோ வாட் ஆர் த கேரக்டர்ஸ் விச் ஆர் அப்பியர்ட் மார்ஃபலாஜிக்கலி ஆர் எக்ஸ்டர்னலி வி வில் பி கன்சிடரிங் ஆஸ் அ ஃபீனோடைபிக். ஸோ ஃபார் எக்ஸாம்பிள் பாயிண்ட் ஆஃப் வியூ, வாட் ஆர் த பாயிண்ட்ஸ் வி ஹவ் டு பி டிஸ்கஸ்ட் மீன்ஸ் ஹியோ. ஆமாம், ஒன் எக்ஸாம்பிள் ரிலேட்டட் டு தி பிளான்ட் லேட்டஸ்ட் டேக்ரா. ஸோ இன் பி பிளான்ட், ஸோ பைசம் சட் ஆஃப் பி பிளான்ட் இஸ் என் தேர் சிங்கிள் ஜீன் இன்ஃப்ளூயன்சஸ். ஆமாம், ஸோ ஒன் சிங்கிள் ஜீன் இன்ஃப்ளூயன்சஸ் சீடு கோட் கலர் and a red spot in the axil of leaf, and one more is a flower color. Amma, one more time, if you take a pea plant, no, there one single gene is present. I mean, so no, one single gene influences three characters. What are those here? Instead of number, I have given stars. Once you see here, one star, two star, three stars means numbers. Amma, which indicates or which gives idea about the numbers. So here, so this one single gene, so where it influences means, or what are the characters it can influence means, so it can influence the seed coat color, and it can influence the red spot in the axil of leaf. Next one, one more is flower color. So likewise, in a pea plant, one gene can regulate three characters. So thereby here, as we have seen in definition, once you see there one gene that can show multiple phenotypic effect. So thereby one gene can control, or one gene can affect, or one gene that can influence many characters. அம்மா புரிஞ்சுதா? ஸோ தட் இஸ் அ பெஸ்ட் எக்ஸாம்பிள். அண்ட் அனிமல் ரிலேட்டட் பாயிண்ட் ஆஃப் வியூ ஆல்சோ ஒன், லெட் அஸ் டேக் ஒன் எக்ஸாம்பிள். வை? பிகாஸ் ஹியர் ஒன் இம்பார்ட்டண்ட் நீட் பிட் இஸ் தேர் டு பி டிஸ்கஸ்ட். ஏமா, நவ் சிக்கிள் செல் அனிமியா, சிக்கிள் செல் அனிமியா. ஸோ தேர் ஜீன் ஹெச்பிஎஸ் அப்படின்னா, ஒன்ஸ் யூ ஓகே ஓகே, ஜஸ்ட் யூ ரிமெம்பர் ஃபார் அ ஃபியூ மினிட்ஸ் அந்த சைடு நோ. ஸோ ஐ ஹாவ் கிவன் சம் அவுட் ஒன் மோர் எக்ஸ்பிளனேஷன் தேர், ஸோ தேர் பை யூ வில் அண்டர்ஸ்டாண்ட் கிளியர்லி. ஓகே, ஸோ இன் சிக்கிள் செல் அனிமியா, ஸோ ஜீன் ஹெச்பி, ஆமாம் ஹெச்பி எஸ்க்கு கொஞ்சம் மேலே இங்கே பவர் விவில் காலில் மேத்தமெட்டிக்ஸ் பாயிண்ட் ஆஃப் வியூ. ஸோ இது எஸ் அந்த மாதிரி பவர் மாதிரி. ஸோ ஹெச்பிஎஸ் ப்ரொவைட் ஏ கிளாசிக்கல் எக்ஸாம்பிள் ஆஃப் அ பிளியோட்ராபிக். இப்போது சிக்கிள் செல் அனிமியா, ஸோ வேர் வி கேன் சி நோ, நாட் இன் பிளான்ட்ஸ், ஸோ எக்ஸ்க்ளூசிவ் வி கேன் சி இன் ஹியூமன் பீயிங்ஸ். ஸோ தேர் பை, ஸோ வாட் இஸ் இன்ஃபர்மேஷன் ஆல்ரெடி வி ஹவ் லேர்ன் இன் அவர் கிளாஸஸ். ஸோ இன் சிக்கிள் செல் அனிமியா மீன்ஸ் இன்ஸ்டெட் ஆஃப் ப்ரொடியூசிங் ஆஃப், ஆர் இன்ஸ்டெட் ஆஃப் ப்ரொடியூஸ் ஆஃப் நார்மல் ஆர்பிசி, சிக்கிள் ஷேப்டு ஆர்பிசி ஃபார்மேஷன் டேக்ஸ் பிளேஸ். தட்ஸ் வை யூ நோ தட் பர்டிகுலர் டிசீஸ் வி ஆர் காலிங் ஆஸ் சிக்கிள் செல் அனிமியா. ஆமாம், ஸோ தட்ஸ் வி நோ வெரி வெல். நவ் ஹியர் வாட் இஸ் அ இன்ஃபர்மேஷன் we are continuing to learn means, so gene HBS provide a classical example of a pleiotropy. Emma, so it is it not only causes hemolytic anemia, so means, so definitely it causes a hemolytic anemia apdena ididara, so instead of normal normal shaped RBC, so sickle shaped RBC formation takes place. Not only that one, but also it also causes or also results increase the resistance to one type of malaria that caused by the parasite Plasmodium falciparum. So means here, what is the point here we are discussing means? So in this particular case, actually when particular what is the information we can discuss here, HBS that provides a classical example of pleiotropy, means one gene is there, HBS gene, so that can regulate many functions or many characters. Once you see there, that gives what is that, hemolytic anemia, one character. So instead of producing of a normal RBC, production of a sickle shaped, that one sickle shaped RBC, adi one. Not only this one more character now we are observing. So what is that? It also results increase the resistance to the one type of malaria. Means suppose this kind of disease, I think so in African peoples or some other people only we will be studying. So what is the point? No, suppose if people are suffering from sickle cell anemia, definitely, indirectly, definitely they can have the resistance to show the resistance against the malaria. Amma purinjuda appadina. Suppose for example, in our body, which one, sickle cell anemia disease is there means, so because of the having of or because of the pleiotropic nature of a HBS gene, we will show the resistance towards the malaria disease. If malaria, we will suffer now. So that is the thing. Means that is caused by which one, parasite, Plasmodium. Yeah, generally, Plasmodium why works, no. But here, Plasmodium falciparum. FALCIPARUM, falciparum. So thereby here, because of the presence of one kind of genes, not two characters we are observing. One is a hemophilic, hemolytic anemia, and one more resistance to malaria disease. I hope you understood this one. Here, one more important point. What are the points here we can discuss now? It better, sir. Okay, ma'am, once you see there, now sickle cell HBS allele also has a pleiotropic effect on the development of many tissues and organs such as bone, lungs, kidney, spleen, heart, etc. Means here, once you see there, now only we see, no, because of the presence of HBS gene, so two characters we see. One is hemolytic anemia, causes hemolytic anemia, and one more is that gives resistance to the malaria disease. In here two characters we see. Next one, definitely sickle cell HBS allele also has a pleiotropic effect. So definitely is to still it can regulate a few kind of pleiotropic effects on the development of many tissues, organs, Emma. So such as bone, lungs, kidney, spleen, etc. And heart, so likewise. So there are means HBS allele or HBS gene, it can show pleiotropic effect. Amma, idi important amma, nalla save pannikonga. Sariya? Next one, ibu somewhat explanation, and now I'll give you related to the which one, normal HBA and mutated. Mutated means sickle celled HBS gene. So what is a phenomenon here we can overtake, or what we can take for our explanation point of view is, once you see that normal HBA gene, so one more time, normal HBA gene. Now let us take here, ipo paathukoinge amma, idu important, listen once. Now here once you see inge 3 prime to 5 prime, here down I have taken. So 3 prime to 5 prime, suppose if you take this one as a double stranded DNA, 3 prime to 5 prime, what is a strand we have to take? Definitely all the time we have to take a template. And what is a strand which is complementary to the template strand? No, that particular strand which is located from the 5 prime to 3 prime, we will be calling as coding strand. Amma, idi konchi important roy. So suppose, I think so, for CBC students I have given. So but or other than them, suppose if any people are studying means, so at a time you have to understand. So what you have to understand here is, suppose if any strand, if we are taking from the 3 prime to 5 prime, that particular strand always will be template. So our convenience point of view, we can take that particular stand as in up or down. Okay, but don't think that a template stand all the time will be upside only, and or don't think a template stand always will be in downside. Okay, so how we have to recognize the template stand means because of the presence of 3 prime to 5 prime. If we are observing 3 prime to 5 prime stand, means that particular stand we have to take it as a template. And what is the stand which is situated complementary to the template from 5 prime to 3 prime, that we have to take it as coding stand. Amma purinjitha ipo paathukko inge. So here it is a template stand. So our knowledge point of view, adenine binds with thymine with 2 hydrogen bonds, and guanine binds with cytosine with 3 hydrogen bonds. Ipo paathukinge CG, TA and GC. So here the complementary is okay. Now ipo paathukinge inge mRNA means by the process of transcription, so mRNA formation takes place. So this particular, what is the mRNA formation takes place? No, that particular mRNA definitely like resembles, like what is the coding strand sequence is there, no, likewise only will be there. Like that only definitely will be there. That's why that particular strand we will be considering as a coding strand. Ippo paathukka ippo mRNA strand, definitely mRNA strand definitely starts with 5 prime to 3 prime. Okay, so that particular point also remember pannikonga. Ippo in coding strand GAG we have taken. GAG we have taken. Now here next one. So here what we are taking? One CC. GAG is there, no? Now in mRNA GAG sequence, what it can produce? What is amino acid it can produce? Means glutamine. So it can produce glutamine. So here, because of the producing of glutamine amino acid in a beta globulin chain, in a beta globulin chain of a hemoglobin. So here what we can observe means the definitely the formation of normal RBC. So the definitely formation of normal RBC formation we can observe. So means in a beta globin chain, so this particular chain 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6th position in a glutamine is there, no, and 7th position. So likewise there are different types of amino acids are present in beta globin chain. Suppose in a 6th position glutamic acid or glutamine is there, means so definitely that particular beta globin chain produce normal RBC, HBA peptide. Suppose you see that sign, sickle cell HBS gene. HBS gene that can produce sickle cell. Sickle cell means adema. So what is the instrument we will use for the cutting of a paddy or wheat, do you know? That is the sickle. Okay, so that one, so how it is a formation taking place means, once let us see. So now 3 prime to 5 prime, one we are taking. So here it is as a template one, and on the side opposite one, what is a strand like a coding strand. Ipu, once you see there, what is the difference between normal HBA and HBS sickle cell HBS, what is the difference? Here GAG we have taken, but here GTG is there, means here adenine is there, but here thymine is there, means definitely mutation taking place at one nucleotide sequence. So, or simply at one nitrogen base. So instead of A, suppose when the place of adenine is replaced by thymine, no? So instead of producing of normal RBC, sickle celled RBC formation taking place. So that particular disease only our convenience to study we are calling as sickle cell anemia. I hope you understood this one. Now here you see there. DNA we took, no, this DNA, double stranded DNA. So from here to mRNA formation takes place. So here in mRNA, here one more point I have to give you. Here thymine will be there, where in a DNA, but instead of a thymine in a mRNA, uracil only must be there. Why? Because adenine always, in case of DNA, adenine binds with thymine, but in case of RNA, adenine binds with uracil, isn't it? So that's why here in this cycle, in this strand, no, we have seen mRNA sequence as GAG, and in this cycle we are seeing that mRNA sequence as GUG. isn't it? So here the this one is GUG. Now you take a beta globin and chain point of view, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5th and 6th position. Now here GUG produces valine. GUG produces valine. So now here this particular valine, so when GUG produces a valine, now instead of producing of normal RBC, so here because of the modified gene, in a 6th position of a beta globin chain, valine is produced. So when glutamine plus is replaced by valine, so at the time instead of normal RBC, sickle celled RBC formation takes place. I hope you understood this one. Suppose if you are unable to understand, watch one more time, definitely you will understand this explanation. Emma, simple ma, here adenine is there and on the side, adenine place replaced by thymine. Ipo adi change aichu in a mRNA only, GAG sequence definitely is there, but when GAG is there, that one forms the glutamine and triplet, three together we will be calling as one triplet now. So next one, and here GTG is there, but likewise GTG will not come. Why? Because the mRNA sequence only, thymine will not be there now. That's why instead of a thymine, uracil will come here. Ipo GUG produces valine. So thereby where in a 6th position of beta globulin chain. So suppose if a valine is there, means a sickle cell RBC formation takes place. Suppose in a 6th position of a beta globin chain, glutamine is there, means normal RBC formation takes place. So that is the explanation of pleiotropic gene in sickle cell anemia related information. So till now we have learned information related to the intragenic allele, or what is an intragenic. So intragenic. So now let us see. Ipo non-allelic interaction or intergenic interaction. Before we have seen what is the allelic interaction, we seen. So up to here, so there are different types of examples we have studied. Now new concept. Ipo one time I'll remind you, once you see there, what is the point? So here there are different types of gene interactions are there, we seen now. So what are the interactions means? So here once you see there, gene interactions, so two types are there, allelic interaction and non-allelic interaction, we seen now. Till now we have seen the information of allelic interaction, Emma. So now we are going to start that is non-allelic interaction. Okay, now here when interaction takes place between the non-allelic, easy only now, when interaction takes place between non-allelic gene or non-allelic is known as non-allelic interaction. It changes or modifies other non-allelic gene. One more time, it changes or modifies other non-allelic gene. Examples of non-allelic interaction. Okay, now let us see. First one is complementary gene. So there in complementary gene, what are the points? Two pairs of non-allelic genes are essential in dominant form to produce a particular character. One more time, once you see there. Two pair of a non-allelic genes are essential. Two pair of non-allelic genes are essential in dominant form to produce a particular character. Means here, yellow and round characters are how we have taken in a dihybrid cross, as a dominant characters. So likewise here also, what is the point? Two pair of non-allelic genes are essential in a dominant form. So definitely two pair of non-allelic genes are essential for the for showing of dominant form to produce a particular character. So now here such genes that act together to produce an effect that neither can produce, its effect separately are known as complementary genes. One more time. So what are the genes are there? The dominant one or the non-allelic genes that act together to produce an effect that neither can produce. Okay. So its effect separately we will be considering as complementary genes. Now here, both types, both types of gene must be present in dominant form. Okay, now here what is the point? Both types of gene must be present in a dominant form. So then only we can observe the formation of one particular character. So when these two different types of genes when will be in dominant state, no, then only we can see the formation of one character. For example, once you see, suppose if you see the example, you will understand clearly. So you'll understand clearly once you see there, what is the point? No, color of flowers in Latin is odoratus. So that is the color of flowers. Color of flowers point of view. Now let us take the example under complementary genes. Once here for understanding point of view, here some odd clue points I have written. Once you see capital C, capital P. Ipo rendu me capitals arukana, definitely color formation takes place. I'm a dominant character da. Okay, now here capital C I have taken and here small p I have taken. Small p how we can recognize, no? So here once you see here no p and here you see there male extra line is there, no? So that's why that one we denoted as colorless. Next one here small c. Small c is also somewhat extra mark I have given, male. So and small c's are there and with capital P is there. So that one also denotes colorless. So thereby, suppose when both alleles or the characters or when both alleles will be in a dominant, no? So definitely that shows the color. Suppose here or here, suppose recessive characters or like dwarf characters are there, means definitely that gives colorless. I hope you understood. Once you see that here capitals are there, here smallers are there, colorless. And here smallers are there and here the capital is there, colorless. But here both are capitals are there, that's why color. Next one more here you see there, here smallers are there and here also smallers are there, colorless. So thereby now did you understand? So if you want to produce the color, means definitely both alleles must be dominant. Okay, so that's why here two pair of non-allelic genes are essential in a dominant form to produce a particular character. Actually these two are non-alleles means here one more allele is there, means allelic, but here one there one both are not alleles. So these two are different. That's why here this particular example we have taken under non-allelic genes. Ippo paathukko inge. So now here it is, these two are parents. What is the parent here? Capital C, capital B with small c with small p. So here one parent and this is another parent. So now the combination of these two in F1 generation, what is the offspring we can obtain? Capital C with small c, capital P with small p. So ipo in the side paathukinge capital C and capital P both are there, no? Definitely both are dominant. So that's why here color formation. So color is produced whether whatever may be the color, purple color they have given. So now here the colored offspring is. Now if you want to, or in order to producing of F2 generation, so what we have to do? F1 into F1 we have to do. So there in F1 into F1 point of view, what are the offsprings we can obtain? Dihybrid cross madriyama. So once you see, so here one important clue I would like to give you. What is that? No, capitals. Listen carefully. So in this checkerboard matto, in Punnett square matto, I have differentiated that one. Capitals I have written with white check piece and smallers now we written with yellow check piece. So that particular differentiation definitely is required. Once you see there, capital C, capital P, capital C, small p, small c, capital P, and small c and small p. Idi four gametes on the side we have taken. So here also same four gametes in the side. Capital C, capital P. Next one, capital C, small p. Small c, capital P. Small c, small p. Ipo paathukke inge. Definitely we can observe 16 offsprings of formation. So ange out of 16 offsprings, if you observe clearly there, while writing I have observed this one there. So what is the point now we are going to learn is, out of 16 offsprings, so 9 are definitely, 9 are colored and 7 are colorless. So once you can observe that, so while watching this particular video, you know, once you stop the video, pause the video, and once you count it, so how many are colored offsprings are there and how many colorless offsprings are there, once you observe, so thereby you will understand one point. So their colored number is 9 and colorless offsprings 7. So thereby color we are observing means color that will be expressed out. So thereby phenotypic character only, no, that one. So their phenotypic ratio is 9:7, means in complementary genes phenotypic ratio is 9:7. So this is somewhat explanation related to the complementary genes. So I have taken not too much of time, but you try to watch this video, so don't skip anywhere. So what is the explanation you are understanding now, directly you write in your notes and one more time write in your mind, so thereby you will not forget. So take care and be safe at home.